Hello, welcome to this new tutorial. Today we are going to talk about liberty, and this talk is divided into following points. First, we will try and understand the meaning and definition of liberty, then development of concept of liberty, next nature of liberty, kinds of liberty, and at last safeguard of liberty. So this tutorial will cover meaning and definitions of liberty, and subsequently next tutorials will cover rest of the points. So let us discuss meaning and definitions of liberty. Now, the term liberty is derived from the Latin word liber, which means free. Therefore, the term liberty has meant different things to different people. In fact, it is not merely a philosophical or legal concept. Rather, in fact, the central theme of liberty is the absence of all restraint and freedom to do whatever one like. माने लिबर्टी एंजॉय करने के लिए कोई कंडीशंस नहीं होने चाहिए और इंसान को पूरी आज़ादी है अपनी स्वतंत्रता और आज़ादी को महसूस करना. वेल, इट इज़ नॉट मेयरली एन आइडिया और आइडियल और स्लोगन और एन इमोशंस, बट इट इज़ अ फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट विदाउट विच मैन इज हार्डली अ मैन. वेल, अकॉर्डिंग टू चेंबर 20th century dictionary, liberty is freedom from constraint, captivity or tyranny, freedom to do as one please, the unrestrained enjoyment of natural rights, power of free choice, privileges, permission, free range, leisure, disposal, the bond within which certain privileges are enjoyed, a limited area outside a prison in which prisoners are allowed to leave, pre-assumption or undue freedom, speech or action violating ordinary civility. So this is the meaning according to Chamber 20th century dictionary. Moving on, according to Columbia Encyclopedia, liberty is a word used to describe various types of individual freedom, such as religious liberty, political liberty, freedom of speech, right of self-defense, and etc. Now, let us discuss about definitions of liberty. According to G.D. H. Cole, liberty is the freedom of every individual to express without external hindrance in his personality. According to Professor Silly, liberty is the absence of restraint or the opposite of over government. According to Hubbard, liberty is the freedom to do whatever one like, provided it does not injure the feelings of others. And according to Gandhi, liberty does not mean the absence of restraint, but it lies in development of liberty. Next, we have Burns. According to him, it means liberty to grow one's natural height, to develop one's ability. Whereas according to Professor Ramsey, by liberty I mean the secure enjoyment of individuals and by natural and spontaneous groups of individuals such as nation, church, trade union, of the power to think their own thoughts and to express and act upon them using their own gift in their own way under the shelter of the law, provided they do not impair the corresponding rights of others. And at last, according to Massimo, liberty is a free choice, each individual's own decisions concerning his own course of action. It belongs to himself, not to the external world that surround him. I hope you have understood the first part of the liberty, which is meaning and definitions of liberty. See you soon in next part of this tutorial, where we will talk about development of concept of liberty.